Everybody's going after the same clients, the same goals, saying the same thing, sending the same postcards, doing the same Facebook ads. How do I stand out? Here's how you stand out. You stand out by showing your prospects that you actually care about what they have going on in their life. You actually show them that you care by never pressuring them to buy or sell a property. You let them do it on their time. You show them you care by asking why they want to buy or sell. Did somebody die? Did their kids go to college? Did they lose their job? Did they get a new job? Why are they wanting to buy or sell? What's going on in their life that's making them make this decision to buy or sell a property? You stand out by being the hardest working real estate agent in your area. How do you do that? How do you prove to people that you're the hardest working real estate agent in the area? By actually being the hardest working agent in your area. Show up to the office earlier than everybody else. Leave later than everybody else. Work the entire day. Stay busy. Make calls. Send emails. Create postcards. Do ads. Create business. Talk to people. Conversation is the key to all closings. Whoever has the most conversations with the most prospects wins. You stand out by being more consistent than anyone else, longer than anyone else. They want the real estate agent who sent them postcards the longest, right? It's not what's in the postcard, it's the fact that they got a postcard from you every single month for the last 10 years. That's why they're gonna choose you. That's how you're gonna stand out. You're gonna stand out because they're getting Facebook ads from you every single day. You're gonna stand out because you answer your phone every single time that they call. You're gonna stand out because you're gonna work hard and you're gonna be patient. You're not gonna want everything today. You're gonna stand out because you don't seem desperate, because you're working with so many different clients that you don't need the sale. You're more interested in how you can actually help them accomplish their goals. If you want to stand out in today's market, use the tools that are right there in front of you and go crush it. Be consistent, show people you care, and watch your business explode. I do my part, right, to where I can go to sleep at night knowing that I did what I had to do. I did everything I could do to try to help them understand. And then it's up to them, you know, and I can sleep good at night knowing that I did everything I could do for them, you know. There's not much else you can do. What you have to do is you got to do at some. There's a part to all this where you got to kind of be selfish, too. You know, where you're, you know, you got to feel good about how you handled the situation to where you can sleep good at night. So you do everything you can do to help them, but then it's up to them. It's just like a listing, right? We go to a listing appointment. They think it's worth god awful amount. You know, we show them the comps. We tell them what we think it's worth, and then it's up to them. We can't do anymore. This is what it is, right? And so it's the same thing with everything: recruiting, listings, helping agents, helping anybody do anything. You just do all you can do for who? For you. No, you do it for you. You do it for you so you can sleep at night. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like the reason why I get up at 4:30 and answer DMs is because I'm doing it for me to make sure that I know I did all I could do to help all those people reaching out, crying for help. Maybe this year you double that, or maybe you hit 250, or maybe you hit 210, or maybe you hit 400, or maybe you hit 600. I don't know, and neither do you. The thing is you put forth the maximum amount of effort. The thing is for me, it's like I just wanna beat my last year. If I can beat my last year and just do better and better every year, and so that's where we only have 24 hours in every day. And so with only 24 hours, you know, in each day, and everybody has the same amount of hours, you get to where you're putting forth as many hours as you can. So then it becomes a factor of, okay, how can we adapt and become more efficient? You know, how can we, as we go along, see these little openings of things that we can do to produce more in less time, but at the same time, still putting in the same amount of hours. So that means, because a lot of people say work hard, work smart, not hard, and they want to produce the same in less time. But what I want to do is produce a lot more in the same time that I'm working. You know what I mean? Like, or people say they want to produce more in less time, and I want to produce more in the same time. I don't want to decrease the hours I'm working. I just want to maximize my efficiency where, you know, I'm producing more. I mean, I'm gonna work every single second of every day. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's, I mean, and I don't care what anybody says or whatever. That's kind of where that is. So let's get into some nuts and bolts now. Should I hopefully be an eye opener, like, and say, okay, aha, it doesn't matter if we do 350 this year, we're gonna do as good as we can. we'll do our best, and maybe we hit that 500 next year. You know what I mean? Because for me, the $1 million, you know, 2014 I hit 600, 15, 600, 16 was 750, and then 17 was a million. So 14, you know, I hit 600 and wanted it the next year, but then it still took me two more years to actually get there.
Okay, it's not a deal, it's a person, it's a human. Okay, so most people look at business and look at sales in terms of transactions. How many transactions did you do? Okay, how do we close deals? All right, how do we handle objections? How do we do this? How do we do that to make people sign the line and do business with us? How do we make people do transactions with us? That's the wrong way to look at the business. Okay, I'm thinking about it like this. A client. Okay, how do I turn one client into 100 clients? When I think about a client, I think about this. I think about multiple deals, okay? I think that particular person is going to do business X amount of times in their life. They're gonna do X amount of transactions. Not sure what the number's gonna be, but it's gonna be more than one on average. Okay, so I want to think about that first. I want to visualize the fact that what I'm talking about here is a human being, okay, not a transaction. My tagline for everything that I do is to value relationships over transactions. When you're talking to prospects, I want you to talk to them in terms of what can we do to help you. Start to understand their motivations. Why do they want to buy or sell whatever it is that they're doing? And then use that to further help them. Until you know why someone wants to buy or sell, you cannot truly help them. And realize that we're only 30 to 60 days away from the market breaking loose. Which way is it gonna go? We don't know. But if it goes down, okay, we're gonna have investors come in. We're gonna sell really good deals on properties. Okay, if it stays the same, that means we're pretty balanced, you know, between investors and first-time home buyers. You know, that if the prices stay the same, that's for a reason, because supply and demand are pretty equal. Okay, and if the prices go up, then that means, you know, there's a lot of demand and hardly any inventory, which inventory is low and interest rates are low. And that's actually a good thing for real estate. That might even help us hold firm a little bit on prices and the market in general. But it's yet to be seen. The good thing is it doesn't matter. The top producers right now, the top producers are taking full advantage of this situation, and they're calling as many people as they can call. Okay, they're calling past clients first and getting through that entire database, and then they're switching over to cold calling. They're calling circle prospecting. They're calling expires. They're calling old buyers. They're calling every single person they can possibly call, because they know that right now is the moment in time where you build your database. You don't have time to build your database when things are moving and grooving and sales are really going great. You don't have time to do it then. So you have to turn around and you have to do it when the market is down. This goes also for when the market slows down during the year.